Greetings, my people. Today, we're going to make a nice dinner. You know the holidays coming up. We're going to make cornbread dressing, cranberry sauce, and roasted cabbage. So let's get going. In our cornbread is already prepared. We want to make this video short. We got our spelt flour instead of white flour, cornmeal, baking powder, and we have baking soda that's not added there. So let's get going. What we're gonna do is put all this into our pan, into a bowl. You wanna break it up real good. This doesn't have any milk in it, any eggs or anything. It's just your corn, you know, it's cornbread. You don't have to add a whole lot of stuff. It's gonna be really good alternative. That's a lot of cornbread. All right, let's break it up. And it's brown because the spelt flour, you know, the spelt flour still has this, the bran in there and the germ. So, you know, that's why it's not white. All right, we already prepared and sauteed our celery, 1 cup of celery, 1 whole onion, 1 bell pepper, and we finally chopped it up and sauteed it in a little bit of grapeseed oil just to give it, you know, some added fat and flavor. So we're gonna add that in there. Keep mixing. This is really, really, really easy to make. The cornbread only takes about 20 minutes. On 360, about 20 minutes to make your cornbread, and then let it rest a little bit. See how that's coming together? All right, we got 1 tablespoon of poultry seasoning, 1 tablespoon of sage. This is a whole leaf sage. About 1 teaspoon of thyme, teaspoon of black pepper, and 1 teaspoon of salt. Those are your key ingredients. You know, the poultry seasoning is really, you know, what makes it, the dressing taste really good. And you'll have to taste it and see, you know, just how you like it. You know, everybody fixes their dressing different. I want to show you something different than using a box. You know what's in your food when you prepare it yourself. Alright, see how fast that's coming together? Okay, I made some stock out of herbs and good fat. This was olive oil in there and some mushrooms, portobello mushrooms, finely chopped. Cumin's in there. It makes it dark because of the mushrooms. You don't want your dressing too dry. You want it kind of wet so it can really cook it up, cook off. This is going to stay in the oven for about 45 minutes to an hour, or depending on, you know, your oven. You don't want it dry. Okay, I already oiled up our pan. I put a little bit of grapeseed oil in the bottom of the pan so it won't stick. Man, I wish you could smell this. All those herbs and spices. No milk, no eggs in the cornbread. All right, okay. Let's put it in here. See how wet that is? And it could be a little bit wetter, but this is gonna cook down really well. All right. Okay, we're gonna put it in the oven. And when it comes out, this is how it's gonna look. Look at that. Set that over here. Okay. Next, we're going straight to making our cranberry sauce. You remember the cranberry sauce in the can? Well, these are real fresh cranberries. You'll need 1 cup of organic sugar. This is 2 squeezed oranges. And about 1/2 cup of concentrated cranberry juice. See how fast we made that cornbread dressing? And neutralize it. Alright. Now you see that? See how they broke open? Alright, that's it. You don't want to overcook them. Okay, that's it. I'm gonna show you how it's gonna look after we refrigerate it. Look at this. See how it gels and come together? Man, that is delicious. Alright. Okay. Okay, now we're doing the cabbage. I've already cut 1/2 of a head up. And see how I'm slicing it? Just kind of, you know, thin, not no big fat chunks. Then I'm gonna break, come across and cut it again. All right. This is a cookie sheet. I've already oiled the bottom of the pan with some grapeseed oil. This is 1 head of cabbage. Okay. Put your oven on broil. You can bake this, but if you put it on broil, it takes it to a whole nother level, you know, in taste. All right, we'll drizzle a little olive oil on top. This is the key to bringing out all that flavor and putting a good fat on here. This olive oil drizzled in. Try to get it all over evenly. Each piece can, you know. All right. This is coming out slow, so it may look like a lot, but it's not. Okay, then we're going to just put some sea salt on there. Some black pepper. And that is it. It's going in the oven on broil for about 10 minutes. Depending on your oven, just watch. Keep a lookout for it. All right, let's go. It's going in the oven on broil. And when it comes out, booyah! It's gonna look like this. Look at that. You know why this is so good? It wasn't boiled in water. No water, just heat. Oil, salt, and pepper. All right, let's plate it up. Look at the dressing. See, it's not all dry. Nice and moist. Look at these cranberries. Oh, man. Look at these cranberries. You know you want some cranberries with the dressing. Look at these cranberries. Look at this crap. Look how it gelled with just those 3 ingredients. Cranberries, oranges, orange juice, fresh squeezed orange juice, and cranberry juice. and some organic sugar. This cabbage. No, there ain't no stopping us. Fly without boarding pass. Y'all know I'm not gonna eat it. You see how little, do y'all see how little my plate is? I did that on purpose. You know, the holidays is coming and we don't want to eat a whole lot. Just eat a little bit at a time. I gotta get a fork. Eat a little bit at a time. Take your time. All right. This is so good. This dressing is so... Let me taste this cabbage. You notice how firm this cabbage is? It's not limp. It's not boiled. It still has its texture. I'm going to have to fight y'all for dinner. All right. You can do this. We do these videos for you. Please share with community. Let me know what you like. Next, we'll be making some greens. Okay? All right. You know we all we eat. I love you. Peace.